and welcome to the Emile Bertin mid-tier gameplay review. And first of all, I want to demonstrate how annoying Emile Bertin can be. I'm playing here my... Congo. And I have Emile Bertin sailing broadside the whole game. I mean, there were situations where he already broadside and he was the whole time broadside. And the only thing I get continuously are overpens. And this is annoying for some battleships with a high caliber like the Congo does, at least for tier 5 with 356 mm. They tend to overpen, and this is like annoying as hell. Which is of course a big strength of the Emile Bertin in general then. I wouldn't say my aim was always on point, but most of the time it was, and I'm hitting. And again, 6 overpens. So you get an idea why I chose the title how like I did. This was anyways a strange game that we lost, but not about the game. It's just about this, how many salvos I need to finish off this Emile Bertin. Normally he just shows full broadside. You just wreck them, right? And another 6 hits, 6 overpens. Of course, it accumulates, but it's annoying, as I said. And that's basically one of the strengths of the Emile Bertin. The Emile Bertin just needs to have, or needs to fear battleships that have lower caliber, like 305, 283 mm, which is on the Kraftspeer and on the Scharnhorst. That are the things that are really hurting you. But that was just a different example. I will head off to the actual replay. Alright, so here we are with the actual kind of commentary. And yeah, I will tell you some things about the Emile, the tier 5 French cruiser. First of all, the Emile is, I would say, one of these ships where you get a clue about how this French cruiser line is supposed to be played, and that's mainly it relies on speed. So the Emile Bertin has no access yet to the, or it's tier 5, so they don't have access to speed boost, but the speed itself, its max speed is already 40 knots, and this is really really fast. And let's give them a hard time. Yeah, this is one of the tools for your survivability. On this map, though, it's hard to rely on your speed since it's so narrow and small. So if I would go full speed in any direction, I would end up in the enemy, in the hands of the enemy within like several seconds or so, or 1 minute, 2 minutes. I mean, if I would go like straight here, then I have no room to maneuver and I'm so close. And even my previous video demonstrated how often you get overpenned. The issue is, when you start to angle in the Emile, you eat citadels, or get actual pens. Of course, as I said, lower AP calibers on broadside does work, so that means you have to be aware, cruiser AP is hurting you a lot, and 203 mm cruiser AP is even overmatching your bow. Keep that in mind. You have, I think, only 13 mm bow armor, which is not much. And therefore you are getting overpenned a lot. So this is a ship you wanna stay like in most of the tier 5, squishy tier 5 cruisers. You wanna stay in the back and do exactly what I do here or demonstrate. Of course I have a favorable matchmaking tier 5, tier 4. But I think the Emile is one of these ships on tier 5 that actually does good in higher tiers as well, or if up tiered. I actually never had issues against tier 6, tier 7s. The issue is maybe that you have a really small HP pool, I think, for your tier, but... Chasseur en vol. Maybe it's not. It's okay. I think the HP pool is in the middle of the bunch, if I'm not mistaken. But still, that is one of the things that stop you of being a bit more aggressive in tier 6, tier 5, tier 7 games. The main armament of the Emile consists of 9 150 2 mm guns, I guess. Something around 150. So if you would slot IFHG, it will greatly, benefit of it. But of course, I don't have a IFHG captain on this because it would like be a bit too crazy, I would say. You have a good fire chance, definitely on the upside, and absolutely noticeable. That Emil in the game before, when I was in the Congo, probably set 7 fires while I was battling 2 DDs plus him, plus the König there. And that was a short duration. So you have now you get a clue, and I have definitely all the reduction tools slotted, so you get an idea how potent it is as a fire starter. What I'm using here mainly is cover. Cover from the rocks, mountains, and shoot over to, shoot the battleships, burn down the battleships, and do such things, which you should know by now how it's supposed. So you use, or how it's supposed to be played, you use your environment. And especially on these narrow maps where you can't maneuver that much, there it's recommended to do exactly like this. Anything else to say? The AA is okay for a ship that has no no access to defensive AA, in my opinion. It's absolutely workable. You have Hydro instead, which is fine. It's basically it. And then you are doing what I'm doing here. If you wonder why I don't shoot here, I think I had to receive a call. Yeah, therefore I get hit a lot. But you saw how many overpens that were? I think 3, 4, maybe 1 pen. And König has only 305 mm guns. So you have an idea what I mean. even after the video I showed you before. So this is one of these tools. You don't wanna angle. At least I don't. I mean, against Scharnhorst, maybe. But Scharnhorst can overmatch you, so Scharnhorst is one of these ships that can actually hurt you if he has the correct aim and knows what he's doing. So be aware of these ships. Scharnhorst and Cruiser AP. And in general, you wanna stay back in the French cruisers. You have no influence on the early game, that's one of the big downsides of the French cruiser line. But if you can conserve your HP till the late game, you can burn down a lot. And that's basically the whole thing about this line. You don't have the best concealment, you don't have the biggest firepower or something like that, not the biggest AG alpha. Not the biggest fire chance, but you have your speed to compensate for that. And you can be an absolute nuisance, especially the higher tier ships are like this, to enemy battleships. So never underestimate that. Emil has a range of 14.9, which is absolutely enough against tier 4, 5 and 6. Against tier 7 it gets a bit iffy. There I would recommend to sit behind islands, definitely, just for the sake of range, because 15 kilometers is not as much, even though if you can show broadside to the enemy. Your biggest issue is if the enemy is shooting HE, because then you get like wrecked completely. If you have HE shooting battleships, that's a nightmare for the Emil. Your rudder breaks like nothing all the time. You lose a lot of HP because your armor is so thin. I would say the Emil is one of these ships where if you switch to HE in a battleship, I would say, yeah, why not? I mean, if you don't have any other targets to shoot, just to get consistency into the damage against the Emil. Because otherwise, you saw what happened to me in the Congo, you get just absolutely burned to a crisp. I mean, it were like 4 or 5 salvos I needed, and I had to hit really good. 6 shells out of 8, this is really good for the Congo. I mean, Congo has a good dispersion, but still, has to be acknowledged. Alright, so I'm moving a bit, or I'm playing now a bit more aggressive. My team seems to be, yeah, doing quite well. So I can play a bit more aggressive. It's only the König that is, yeah, König and the Rhine. And my carriers do a lot of work to, taking them out. I want to again go to the middle and maybe see if I can pick up a DD, because with a speed of 40 knots, you have a good chance of picking up destroyers as well. It's a very good thing, actually. They can't run from you, and you have access to hydro, and then you can just hunt them down. And yeah, since most low tier DD players are a bit... yeah, they just sit in smoke, have no clue maybe if they're what hydro is, and then they are surprised what's going on. And there we go, T22 is spotted, set too long in his smoke, and that's... he can't get away anymore. See, the HE alpha of a broadside is quite good. Okay, 7 hits. But still. The carrier is coming for me. But I finished off the T22, as I said. He was not able to run away, and people are completely underestimating the speed, because on this tier there people are not familiar with everything, with anything. I mean, it's protected matchmaking, a lot of beginners, so it's an easy grind. By the way, you have also torpedo armament, 6 kilometers now. In former times it were 9, and it's sad that they nerfed it. They also nerfed the reload time. I think the Emir was way stronger a year ago or so. But the nerf of the torpedoes is a big thing. With the 9 kilometers that you have from tier 6 on, I mean, you won't hit much, but it can be a nuisance from time to time. So don't want to go too close to the Kaiser. Also 305mm guns, I try to avoid him. Because this is actually the guns I'm really worried about, nothing else. Alright, Hosho, and now I can play it down. So torpedo armament, you have pretty good top angles, so if you go in a 1 versus 1 against another cruiser or so, you can capitalize on that, that's for sure. Top angles on the French cruisers is pretty awesome, to be honest. Here I can't use them, I'm not as close, and normally you don't want to be close, but against other cruisers with not 203mm, you can charge in. There's a possibility of doing so. And yeah, I can have quite good results. I mean, this is not the most of damage that I did, but I took out the DD. I think XP wise it should look quite good, and therefore I'm absolutely satisfied with this performance. But I can remember with the old Emil I had games over 100k. I wouldn't say easily, but definitely reliably. It's not as easy anymore since they really nerfed the rate of fire. I think it's 1 or 2 seconds, I don't know. Probably this ship was overperforming, because otherwise it wouldn't make any sense. So Acasta spotted, that's the next on my list. Someone kills the Hosho. And same here. So I expect him to torp, so I'm turning in. It's just basic stuff. My hydro is ready. Also in a sec. Now he's shooting, which makes it even easier for me. Now I don't even need to chase him at all costs. Yep, there we go. Torpedoes. As expected. If you come around this and you are spotted and a DD is crossing this path, you can always expect torps normally if he has some available. That's a pretty simple thing in this. Not low tiers, it's in general. I wonder how many people always run into torpedoes, which are, in my opinion, really obvious. That they, of course, not always they will be there, but that depends on the availability. But yeah, be aware that this is often the case. So, taking off the Acasta, capping now, and then there's only one Suyo left, and yeah. That is basically it, I would say. Pretty, I wouldn't say awesome game, but it should show you how you can play the Emir. Or you can play like the other guy in the other replay, just prod that on. Don't care about battleships and have fun for your life. Actually, if you want to do this broadside on thing, I can recommend to wiggle a bit. So use the Q and E keys on the keyboard, and just wiggle a bit to the left, a bit to the right, but not that you angle too much. But it's just to throw off some aim, and don't try to. And that's the thing, that a really common mistake in French cruisers. If you want to avoid a normal cruiser, if you play different cruisers than the French cruisers, then you like slow down a bit and then turn in. If you do that in the in the Emil or in other French cruisers with speed boost, the enemy will most likely hit you, because normally their aim is not on point, and therefore you eat more damage than you should. So just that you know. Alright, so we have made almost 80k, 3 kills, 10 plane kills, okay. As I said, the AA is quite okay for tier 5, and against tier 5, 4 carriers, it's doing fine, I guess. 9 fires on 138, could be better, could be worse, I saw worse, definitely. 3 caps, all fine. Yeah, as I said, basic speed 1700 as a top tier in this matchmaking is definitely a challenging result. I think you can't get that any day. I think it's, if you have 1400, 500 basic speed, this is already a lot. So I was really, really happy with my game here, and the basic speed shows it. Maybe a thing I didn't talk too much, the AP is also potent if you have flat broadsides on shorter distances, because 152 millimeters, so, but normally you don't go that close in the beginning, so you stay more in range and handle the battleships more, so you're not a especially good cruiser killer in my opinion. But if you need to shoot AP, it's potent, it's definitely potent, and has enough penetration value to penetrate the broadsides of cruisers, that's for sure. Alright, yeah, that's it about the Emil. Hope that helped and showed you a bit how to grind your way on the French cruiser line. There will be another one about the La Galésinière soon, I hope. I'm busy, I'm really busy. So don't wonder. Yeah, apart from that, I wish you a nice day and see you next time. Bye-bye.